In the energy quadrant, taking a look at the August crude oil contract, which resulted in a small rally from an orderly day of price moves. On the upside today, we were up about 1.25% at 73.81. On the downside, we were down about 1.25% at 71.97, getting just below that 72 level. 1.28 was the low in terms of percentage change. 1.23 was the high in terms of percentage change. That's what I call orderly trade. And that resulted in a small rally up about 0.33%, just over 73, 36 basis points positive in terms of the actual close, to be exact. Now, OPEC was definitely in the headlines. OPEC and OPEC Plus meet on Thursday to discuss supply for the further out months. They've already got June and July locked in, and with oil at its highest level since 2018, according to Reuters, sources are saying more production in August is going to be discussed, although some countries are reportedly worried about higher supply out of Iran. OPEC's latest demand forecasts say that if their output stays the same, supply would fall short of demand by 1.5 million barrels in August and then 2.2 million barrels in the fourth quarter. And that's likely why we've got a little bit of a bid to us, because OPEC is notoriously unreliable in what leaks out to the press versus what happens in the actual meeting. But we'll find out. That meeting is on Thursday. And recent dollar strength seems to have legs as well. That dollar strength could be a little bit of a headwind to crude oil, but hasn't been lately, to be honest. The dollar fell Monday and Tuesday of last week, but since then, it's kind of stabilized and started to move higher again, working on its fifth week higher in the last six, and the second strongest month of the year, potentially. June is up about the same as 2 months ago, but then you go back for the entire year, and it's really right there as being the strongest 2 months. So you're talking about April and June being the strongest months for the dollar so far this year.